Hi everyone, I'm your friend Avinash. Welcome to my channel, The Learning Destination, and today's topic is Kubernetes. In this session, we are trying to cover the entire phases of Kubernetes. In the first sections, we try to understand what is container and orchestrations. Then we will see that the Gartner Magic Quadrant on different cloud providers. Then introductions about the Kubernetes. We'll see that where to use Kubernetes. Then availability on AWS, the same for GCP, cloud, Google Cloud Platform. And then we will see that the component, we understand that what is master component and what is node component in Kubernetes clusters. Then we will see that the architectures. We will also discuss about the add-ons on Kubernetes cluster. In the last, we will see that what are the packages are required to install Kubernetes clusters. So without any further delay, let's start with Kubernetes cluster. We try to first understand why Kubernetes came into the picture and why it is highly demanding technology nowadays. To understand these things, we need to understand there is some limitations with container services like virtual machines. Let's suppose that you are using public cloud, and as per the uses of CPU, memory and storage, you are paying for that. But simultaneously, you need to also keep track of the unused VMs. Like if there is any other instances running which is no longer in use, and still you are paying for that. Simultaneously, you need to also take care of that. When the load increases, you need to make the availability of instances so your load can be balanced. And that's why the orchestrations comes into the picture. And here the Kubernetes came into the picture. In the first segment, we talk about container and orchestration. Container keeps your application separately into its own operating system environment. Through the container, your application software can development, shipment, and deploy. Container alternative is virtual machines. If I talk about the container alternative, there is alternative in terms of virtual machines available and physical machines. There are various containers available in the market. There are various vendors in the market like Docker, Arhcitecture, Guardian, LXC, Apache, Mesos. Orchestrations. Orchestration is a method to automate scale and coordination of containers and connect to the worlds. If I talk about the alternative of orchestrations, then you can write some script or program or do the static configurations between containers. There is also the vendors in orchestrations like Kubernetes, Docker Swarm, AWS ECS, and Apache Mesos. We try to understand through the Gartner Magic Quadrant where the top public cloud providers. If I talk about the niche players, then IBM, Oracle, and Alibaba Cloud exist there. If I talk about late 2016, then Google was also falling in visionaries areas, but nowadays it is falling in leaders category. There is Microsoft, and still Amazon Web Services is dominating the cloud infrastructure industry. Here the introductions about the Kubernetes. Kubernetes first came from the Google internal project in mid-2014. Project name was Google Borg. So first, the Kubernetes is developed by the Google Cloud, and since Google it using its high scale machines using this from last 10 years. Kubernetes also known by the name K8S, that is Kubernetes, which is Greek word and known as the pilot. Kubernetes first release was in July 2015. Google established a partnership with Linux Foundation and formed Cloud Native Computing Foundations for offering Kubernetes as an open source. Friend, CNCF is Cloud Native Computing Foundations, is open source software foundations dedicated to making cloud native computing sustainable, and universal. Cloud native computing foundations making a software stack by applications as a microservices, and each part of the microservices it includes inside its own container. Kubernetes is container orchestration tool. Orchestration depicts automated arrangement, coordination, and management of complex computer system. Next topic is where to use Kubernetes. It depends on you. What is your role? Who you are? It depends on you whether you are developer, whether you are trainer, or you are using for the production purpose. It can be deployed on cloud provider or bare metal. If I talk about the development, then developer can use a minikube. Minikube is a Kubernetes cluster which you can deploy it on one single node machine. You can also call it dev cluster on a cloud provider. In the training purpose, you can also use minikube. Kubernetes availability on AWS. As we have seen in our Gartner Magic Quadrant rule, like every public cloud infrastructure vendors are trying to achieve Kubernetes services and offering Kubernetes services. As of now, AWS doesn't provide Kubernetes services, but what it provides is Elastic Container Services, ECS, where you can, as a container services, AWS provides services, ECS, Elastic Container Services. And if you want to deploy the Kubernetes services, you can create the EC2 instances and you can deploy the Kubernetes instance using KOPS cluster managing services. AWS joined CNCF and supports Kubernetes project in some form. Very soon, AWS will provide Kubernetes services. So there are in line of, so the different vendors like Google, Microsoft, and Amazon, all these top vendors are trying to achieve an offerings Kubernetes as a service. At present, Kubernetes can be deployed directly on AWS EC2 instance using KOPS and manually. KOPS is a tool and used to install Kubernetes upgrade and management currently maintained by CNCF. Kubernetes support by GCP, Google Cloud Platform. As we know that Kubernetes is the part of Google Cloud Platform, has high level support for Kubernetes through its Google Container Engine, GKE. User can deploy cluster using KOPS or manually or Google Compute Engine VMs. You can deploy 5-node cluster without any additional charge, but it charges for VMs running inside the cluster on Google Cloud Platform. Kubernetes component. So the component has been divided in two category, master component and node component. In master component, the first comes Kube API service. It exposes the Kubernetes API on master nodes. It works as a front end for the Kubernetes control panel. Like it takes the request from kubectl, that is called Kuber command line tools. It takes the setup instructions and pass it to rest of the service through Kube API server. etcd, consistent and highly available key value store used as a Kubernetes backing store for all cluster data services. It is like, it acts like a database, or we can say that it is the database in the Kubernetes cluster, which keeps the record of the Kubernetes cluster. Like if we host any applications and we use MySQL or any other DB in the same manner, here in Kubernetes, we use etcd. Kube scheduler, it watches newly created pods that have no node assigned and select node for them to run on. So basically, it takes the responsibility that which node is assigned to which pod, whether the newly created pod, whether there is node added or not. So it takes all these responsibility. Kube controller manager, it runs controller. Cloud controller manager runs controllers that interact with the underlying cloud providers. Node component. In the node component, the first comes kubelet, an agent that runs on each node in the cluster. It makes sure that containers are running in a pod. So kubelet is a service which is running on each node in clusters. It means that it first gets the set of instructions command from the master component or from the master node, and then it accordingly it sends request to pod to serve that request. Kubeproxy, it maintains the network rules on host and enables Kubernetes service abstractions. Kubeproxy is responsible to expose the port numbers of the application to interact with the outside. Container runtime, it is a software which is responsible for running container. Kubernetes supports various runtime, Docker, Arhcitecture, and run, etc. Pods, then pods is also a very useful and very essential part of the Kubernetes. Pods is basically a group of containers. Pods are collected group of applications container with shared volumes. Now let's understand architecture wise how Kubernetes look like. See, any developer, engineer, if they made applications and they run it through the Kubernetes. Now in the Kubernetes master, as we have seen in the previous part, there is API server, scheduler, which decide that which pod where this particular services should be run on which node. Then there is controller manager, and in, as we have seen in the previous part, Kubernetes nodes, there is kubelet service, kubeproxy, pod, and Docker container engine, that is Docker. We are using here the Docker. So the this kubelet part first takes the set of command instructions from the Kubernetes master, and then it passes to the pod. Then pod serves that request, and it says to the kubeproxy to serve this request on certain port numbers. Then these all phenomenon or all these records will be saved into the etcd. So later on, Kubernetes can ask to serve these requests, and we can the users can see the cluster records in etcd database. And in this way, that the users, application and users, can take the in this way, this Kubernetes nodes serve the request of the requester. There is load balancer. So this Kubernetes master, I have shown here only one the node, but it can be multiple. You can make a cluster of the master as well. Like you can put 2-3 nodes, or in the same way in the Kubernetes nodes, you can also maintain a clusters. So this load balancer takes care of that. If one node goes down, it decides and it connects you to the second node. So the request can fulfill without any delay. There is some add-ons on Kubernetes. DNS. Cluster DNS is a DNS service. Kubernetes has its own DNS server. All Kubernetes clusters should have cluster DNS. Container started by the Kubernetes automatically include this DNS server in their DNS searches. Then web user interface dashboard, which provides the facility of user interface web-based container resource monitoring. It is used to record time series metrics of containers in central database and provides user interface for accessing that data. Cluster level logging, it saves the container logs. If you want to deploy the Kubernetes, then following package you should install on your machines: kubeadm, kubelet, kubectl, again the kuber command line tools, and minikube. Minikube is optional. If you are going for productions, then you need to only install kubeadm, kubelet, and kube command line tools, that is called kubectl. And if you want to deploy and want to make a single node clusters, then you can use it minikube. Okay friend, that's it for today. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe it. Also, please press the bell icon so you will get the notification on my latest videos. Please share your feedback, your comment. You can follow me on LinkedIn and Facebook. The link are given below. Thank you very much for watching it.